Welcome back to my channel. What the fuck is that? I'm gonna ask you guys to ignore whatever the fuck this is. And my chair. So today we are gonna be talking about weight loss maintenance, or more specifically how I have maintained my 130-pound weight loss. Just a disclaimer, as I'm sure a lot of you already know, I've technically only been maintaining for about a year and 8 months, which I know to a lot of people isn't long enough to be considered like maintenance. However, I obviously, I don't know how long I'm going to have this channel, and instead of me waiting a couple years to, you know, have the credibility to make this video, I figured I would just make it now, so you guys can see it now. It's better to see it sooner than later. I also wanted to say that I have been maintaining within about 10 pounds. I've lost 130, so to me, 10 pounds is pretty good, but a lot of you guys know I struggle with binge eating, so I'm usually, I range between 170 and 180. And when I'm binging, I'm obviously on the higher end of that scale. And when I'm doing well, I'm on the lower end. So I actually haven't gained, I would say, more than 4 pounds of fat. But in terms of actual water weight and bloat weight from binge eating, I do fluctuate about 10 pounds. Okay, so let's jump right into it. If you guys have been on my channel or you have watched some of my Q&As, you will know that my favorite word when it comes to weight loss is sustainability. So what I mean by sustainability is something you can sustain. Duh! You've probably heard many times that it is not a diet, it's a lifestyle.
It's a lifestyle!
And it is so, so, so fucking true. The most important part, in my opinion, to be able to maintain your weight is to create sustainable lifestyle changes as you lose weight. So what I mean by this is when you commit to losing weight, you want to do so in a way that you are going to be able to maintain and sustain once you reach your goal weight. What we see a lot of, especially in the time of such prominent and dominant diet culture, is that a lot of people will go to pills, to shakes, to pre-bought meals, to all of these crash diets or secrets or, you know, miracle to lose weight. And while these products often work, they often do not do a great job at promoting long-term or sustainable weight loss. And the reason that is because, in my opinion, they teach a lot of people nothing. they work, but they don't explain why they're working. And since those people don't understand why they have worked, when it's actually time to maintain, they don't have that knowledge to kind of go forth. Basically, they are either completely tied to the program because all they know is that that program works, or they're destined to, you know, gain the weight back because for whatever reason, they can't do that program anymore and they didn't have the knowledge to maintain it themselves. Think of it this way. In a year from now, let's say you have no access to any weight loss tools. You don't have access to your favorite shakes. You don't have access to your prepaid meals, whatever. You don't have access to your pills. Anything like that, would you be able to maintain or even continue your weight loss journey without any of those tools? If your answer is no, then that's when we see a really big gap in knowledge when it comes to weight loss, and that's what you do not want. You do not want to be left in the dark. You want to be able to end your weight loss journey and have the knowledge and have the confidence to go to the next step, which is maintenance. You might not always be able to afford meals. You might not always be able to afford shakes. These things are expensive, and these things are not, it is not normal for you to spend that much money for the rest of your life on these weight loss tools when you could easily learn it yourself. And that's the main thing I'm trying to, you know, get across. There's one reason why diets work. There's one reason why your pre-bought meals work. There's one reason why your shakes are working. And that is because it is putting you in a caloric deficit. If you want a successful maintenance period, you need to take the time right now to understand why you are losing weight. For example, let's say you are buying pre-bought meals, which is fine. If that's a tool you need, then that's fine. What's not fine is you using that tool until you reach your goal weight and then just kind of hoping for the best, because that's not probably going to end up too well. Let's say you are eating 3 pre-bought meals a day, and these 3 meals you know are working, so you continue to eat them. Now let's say you can't afford them anymore. Let's say one of them was spaghetti. So you know in your mind that that pre-made spaghetti meal was okay. So let's say you start making that at home instead. The problem we see here, and the problem that arises, is that you were taught that spaghetti is okay, but you were not taught why that spaghetti was okay. So yes, you can eat the spaghetti if it's in the pre-bought meal when it's loaded with sodium and has a lower calorie count, but when you make it at home and you make it in a way bigger portion with way more calories, it's not gonna have the same effect on your body. But people get in the mindset of not understanding why it worked and just that it worked. And when you get into that mindset, you don't actually understand, and you're not gonna be successful when it comes to maintenance. Best investment you can make during your entire weight loss journey, during your entire maintenance period, is learning how shit works. And it's for people who don't understand this that they start to see a lot of fluctuation following weight loss. And I mean, don't get me wrong, you do see a lot of fluctuation among people who have this knowledge as well, myself included. I'm like the best example. But that's kind of when you factor in external factors. So like a binge eating disorder, for example, or some other type of disorder that is kind of prohibiting someone from utilizing the knowledge they know. But there's a difference, right? Because at least if I binge eat, I understand what the outcome of that binge eating is going to be. And that actually encourages me not to binge eat. Or if I binge eat, I understand that I just need to go back into a deficit for a while. And that knowledge is so good to have for someone who is facing the possibility of regaining weight. Especially for someone who is so locked in this mode of restriction, if you at least understand why you gain that weight, you can understand it's easy enough to lose it again. And then you don't get stuck in the mindset of like hopelessness, like I'm gonna regain everything. All I'm saying is try your best to develop sustainable lifestyle habits now. Don't start eating 1,000 calories a day. You are not gonna be able to eat 1,000 calories a day for the rest of your life. Do not start exercising 6 hours a day. You will not be able to exercise 6 hours a day for the rest of your life. Work towards developing something sustainable so that when you reach maintenance, you can maintain it. What I try to remind people is that these programs and these tools don't really want you to have long-term success. And I know that fucking sucks and it's shitty, but it's true. Like, they make money off of selling you products. So obviously, their idea of a successful like business would be to have you continue to buy their products. But it's the people who use their products to lose weight, stop using it, see the regaining, and quickly go back. That's their target audience, people who they can keep on forever. It is just very important to understand the role of nutrition, I guess, is basically what I'm trying to get at. And I mentioned this in a lot of my videos, and I really hope that you guys, since watching me, or if you're new, once you start watching me or whatever, I hope that you really understand that weight loss is very straightforward and it's not as complex as you think it has to be. We are told weight loss is complex because it is a marketing scheme. Like, people want to sell you stuff to lose weight. The only way to lose weight is to eat in a caloric deficit. So even if it's a program being sold to you, the only reason it's working is because they are putting you in a caloric deficit. There's no magic, like fucking fairy dust in their damn, I don't know, like pre-made spaghetti. Like, there's fucking nothing. These shakes don't contain any like magical chemical. It's just putting you into a deficit. Just like when you gain weight, you are eating in a surplus. So you really do not have to be afraid of maintenance, right? Because once you understand that you just have to eat to your maintenance calories and you won't regain weight, it becomes a lot more, like, it's easier to cope with. Because I know, trust me, I know how hard it is to get out of the mentality of losing weight. And I know because I'm still in it, because I still want to lose 15 pounds. I've wanted to lose 15 pounds for fucking year and a half. How hard it is to just accept and be like, okay, it's time for maintenance. Like, I understand the idea that restriction is like all you know. You know what I mean? Because I am so stuck in the cycle of restriction binging. But at the end of the day, I am confident that even if I binge really badly, like really, really fucking badly, I will never go back to where I was because I know how not to. Try your best to lose weight in a healthy way. And I know that's like the most boring shit ever. And I know when anyone wants to lose weight, they want the secret. But the truth is, there's no secret.
There's no secret!
You don't need programs. And like I said, if you want to use a program, that's fine. Like, if you want to use a tool, that is fine. But I'm telling you, you need to understand why that tool worked. So when you're done using that tool, you don't regain. It's just calories in, calories out. That's how it's going to be for the rest of your life. I hope this video was helpful. I know for a lot of you, it is very straightforward information. I just wanted to make this video for those of you who are maybe confused, maybe intimidated, anything like that. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye! Bye!
Fuck your Bible, lady!